Where did this message come from? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for AskLeo.com. I think we've all run into it from time to time. A message box shows up on the machine and you have absolutely no idea where it came from. Here's a question that's just one example. On my wife's computer, when she signs on, she gets this message in a small rectangular box. Error, unexpected error, quitting, with an OK button. The message comes on when she signs on and stays on the screen for 2 minutes and then disappears. Or I can click it off anytime. Is there any way we can get it to stop? The real question here is, where's that message box coming from? If we were to understand that, then we probably would have a clue as to what to do to make it stop. Fortunately, there's a tool, a free tool from Microsoft that will help us do exactly that. Here we are in Windows 11 and there's a message box. And in fact, you'll notice the message box really gives us no indication of what program is generating it. Now, to be totally transparent, you'll notice down in the lower left-hand corner, there's a couple of partially obscured windows. That's what I had to do to make this happen. But it's going to be illustrative of exactly how we understand where this message box came from. Step one is to install the SysInternals suite from the Microsoft Store. This is a free collection of very useful tools, and the one we're going to use is probably the one I use the most frequently. So, SysInternals suite in the Microsoft Store, and again, it's free. I already have it installed, but if you don't, this is how you would get it. So we will click on the Start button, and depending on whether you're running Windows 10 or Windows 11, you may find it in two different locations. I'm going to go ahead and click on All Apps. In some cases, you'll find it directly under Process Explorer. Now you'll notice that that's not here in my alphabetical list. That's because in Windows 11, it actually shows up in SysInternals Suite, with then the collection of all the tools. I'll click on Process Explorer, and I'm actually going to go ahead and just move it off to one side. And the error message, I'm actually going to move over here just to have both things on the screen easily at the same time. The feature, the key to this technique is this weird looking icon right here. It's under the users menu. It kind of sort of looks like a target. I refer to it sometimes as a sonar screen. But the bottom line here is this is the tool that we use. What we do is we click and hold on that target icon and then drag it. We will drag it and drop it onto the message box that we don't understand. You'll notice that the window actually highlighted, so we know exactly what we're about to drop it onto. When I release the mouse, now what's happened is that Process Explorer over on the right-hand side has highlighted the application to which that message box belongs. In this case, it's Notepad.exe. And indeed, that's because Notepad is what I used to make this error happen. But regardless of what program actually is responsible for that, you'll then see it highlighted in the list of running software that Process Explorer is able to identify for you. What happens next? Well, that depends on what you find out. It may be very obvious. Like in this case, my solution is don't do that with Notepad. But you may find out that it's from an application you recognize and it's giving you an error that you understand and that you just know how to fix. It may be that it's an error from some startup program that you no longer need. It may be an error that's left over from a partially uninstalled software package. Or, worst case, it may be malware. It could be something that shouldn't be there at all, in which case you would run a complete anti-malware scan just to make sure. But the bottom line here is that this technique using the sonar icon in Process Explorer will let you identify exactly what program is displaying what window when you can't figure it out based on the window's contents. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit AskLeo.com/2022. 2577. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.